Chairs No Waiting, episode number 484, Battle of Chateau Thierry update. Two Chairs No Waiting is brought to you each week by the folks over at weaversdepartmentstore.com. Drop by over at Weavers and pick up some of the Andy Griffith Show's 1967 Mayberry squad cars. You know, little 1/64th scale matchbox car size. Head over there and pick those up. Great t-shirt, by the way, over here, the Andy Griffith, Andy Taylor t-shirt, the sheriff t-shirt. It's a great shirt just to wear around and visit with folks. Folks love it. Head over to Weaver's Department Store and check it out. Two Chairs No Waiting is also brought to you by donations from listeners like you. The executive producer of episode number 484 is James Middelton. Hello, everybody. I'm Alan Newsom, your host for Two Chairs No Waiting. And thank you, James, for helping support the show. He supported the show by giving me some feedback this week, and that's what we're going to be talking about. That's right. So last week's episode was, you know, when was the Battle of Chateau Thierry? Or something like that was the name of it. But that was what it was about. So if you didn't hear it, go back and listen to it, because I gave some controversial, other hard words to say, information about the Barney riding across, or Barney's motorcycle that was the first motorcycle to cross the river, the Marne River, the Battle of Chateau Thierry, June 12th, 1918. The passenger was Black Jack Pershing, and the driver was Corporal Nate Jackson, A.E.F. Now, that's what we talked about last week, and guess what? We're talking about it again. And it's only fitting. It was the 100th anniversary a week or so ago, a couple of weeks back. And so it was the 100th anniversary of that important riding. Now, last week, I told you guys that I thought perhaps the dates were wrong, because everything I had been seeing was telling me that the Battle of Chateau Thierry actually happened in July, not in June. So, but I got some feedback from one of our listeners, fellow listeners, and it just happens to be James. So James wrote me, and here's what he has to say. James Middelton, this is him. He wrote me last Thursday, and he said, the episode you were referring to in your podcast about Two Chairs No Waiting, you were asking for the correct dates for the Battle of Chateau Thierry. He says, I'm not a historian, but I have three books that include the battle, and they all three list the battle dates as stated below. Okay, so here's what the information he gave me. The battle date they gave of June 12th, 1918 would have been correct. The battle took place the 3rd of June through the 26th of June, 1918. The German High Command recognized that a window had opened in the spring of 1918. Revolution had forced Russia to withdraw from the war allowing Germany to transfer troops from the Eastern to the Western Front. The battle was relatively brief, and American forces met with French allies at the Marne on June the 3rd and forced the German forces back across the river. At Belleau Woods, however, the battle raged for 3 weeks. Okay, so 3 weeks from June 3rd. Okay, so that would definitely fit the 12th. It raged for 3 weeks. In the first phase, the Germans assumed the offensive, trying to advance on June 3rd against the U.S. Marines manning shallow trenches. The French commanders had urged the Americans to fall back, but dramatically, according to legend, the Marine commander responded, retreat. There's another word I'm not going to say because we're a family show. We just got here, is what he says. And their dogged defense force of forced the Germans to retreat and then settle into a defensive position of their own. Almost 2,000 Americans died during these attacks. Wow. But by June 26th, they had taken Belleau Wood and forced the Germans into a fight. So that's what had happened. Okay, so that was in that time period, which would have been June 12th. And he also goes in, since we're talking about this, last week we talked about the motorcycle that was in the episode was actually a 1927 Harley Davidson, not 1918. He says, as to the year of the motorcycle being incorrect, you got to remember that the motorcycle was not supposed to be the original motorcycle. It was a battle that Andy had selected to make Barney think it was a historical motorcycle, which is true. And he says, wonderful episode. I always appreciate it. So here's this is James Middelton. Thank you so much, James. He's got a little bit more. The first source for this information, by the way, because I asked him, where did you get this information? Because I wanted to see. There's a book called Marshal Ferdinand Foch, His Life and His Theory of Modern War. Okay, so that's that was one of the books. Let's see here. I think that's there it is. I went out and found it as well. And then the other books were, the second source was the Second Battle of the Marne. And he thinks it was published in about 2008. And then there was a third book called The Chateau Thierry in Belleau Woods, 1918, America's Baptism of Fire. He said, here's what he went on to further tell us. He said, I believe that it is because there being two Battle of the Marne events, the first being in 1914, if his memory serves him correct, it ended in August or October of 1914. The second battle, from July to August 1918, the second battle was the last major German offensive. The first Battle of the Marne is also referred to as the Battle of Chateau Thierry, but it was actually closer to Mox, which is east of Paris. I think many people aren't aware that there were two battles that refer to the first battle as the Battle of Chateau Thierry. So he had written this. So thank you so much there. So Andy Griffith's show was actually probably correct then. That's the reason, I was confused last week as we were going through this, trying to understand why people weren't upset or didn't comment about the incorrect date. Because I would have thought at that time there would be people that were either alive that had been in that battle, or at a minimum, their children would have been in there. So he gave us two references for books. And one of them was Chateau Thierry and Belleau Woods. And I went out and I found these things on Google. They're Google books. You could buy them. They're online books. And the second one was the Marshal Ferdinand Foch book, His Life and His Theory of Modern War. Now, this was written in 1918, by the way. Okay, so this is right after it. So here's a passage from that book. Okay, so here's what it says. I'm going to get in here and just get into part of it. This is talking about June the 11th. Okay, so it said Foch made a local counterattack on a wide front on June the 11th and regained some ground. Further to the right, General Pershing came into action with the first American divisions that were ready to take the field as an independent unit. By a series of splendid attacks, he prevented the enemy from issuing westward along the Marne from Chateau Thierry. And the little town gives its name to the first victory won by the troops of the United States in the Great War in France. Boom. There it is. So that was June the 11th when that battle occurred. So June the 12th is when he crossed the River Marne on the motorcycle. Boom! I am so happy that the Andy Griffith Show was historically accurate. So this book, written in 1919, that's about as close to the actual subject as we're going to get. Is from somebody giving a report. So there it is. There was a battle going on June the 11th. And then it talks about Pershing was involved in this battle, and the Americans, we fought there. Boom. Boom. First victory won by the troops of the United States in the Great War in France. Thank you. Thank you. So great job. I really, really want to thank James, because I have searched everywhere else on the internet and could not find that exact reference. But that clears it up for me. So now we can all rest happily knowing that the Andy Griffith Show and the motorcycle, the information was right. So indeed, it is possible that that was the first motorcycle, except it was a 1927 motorcycle, but that there could have been a first motorcycle that crossed the River Marne at the Battle of Chateau Thierry on the 12th of June, 1918, with Black Jack Pershing as a passenger, and maybe even Corporal Nate Jackson as the driver. Ladies and gentlemen, boom, drop the mic. We got it. So thank you, Andy Griffith Show. Thank you again, James, for giving us that great information. Oh, the stress from last week is relieved. I'm so glad so many people actually enjoyed this. I realize this is barely Andy Griffith Show related, but it was bothering me because, you know, I can't believe that they got this wrong, and they didn't. So thank you to the people that helped me figure out that I was not, or the Andy Griffith Show was not incorrect, that it was right. So thank you so much. All right, so that's it. The horse is dead. We beat that horse to death. Folks, we have a great report from our roving reporter, Randy Turner.
Welcome to This Week in Mayberry History, a report by special correspondent Randy Turner of the Gomer and Cooper Pyle Comic Book Literary Guild of the Mayberry Historical Society.
Barbara Perry was born on June the 22nd, 1923, in Norfolk, Virginia. Her mother was a soprano in the chorus of the Metropolitan Opera. Barbara's parents separated when she was a young child. As her mother could not afford child care, she solved the problem by signing Barbara up to be in the Met's Children's Ballet Corps. It was the beginning of Barbara's lifelong love of dance. She made her film debut when only 10 years old in the John Barrymore dramatic film Counselor at Law. After appearing in another film while still a child, she was an uncredited featured dancer at the age of 21 in the comedy Hi, Beautiful. While she did have a few more film roles in the 1940s, she concentrated her career on the stage. She headlined many top-level nightclubs as a solo dancer and made her Broadway debut in 1946 in the play Swan Song, followed almost immediately by the short-lived If the Shoe Fits. In 1950, she was in another Broadway musical that closed after only 2 days. Her next theater experience led to her television debut, but in England, before she ever appeared on TV in the United States. A new version of an earlier failed musical called Zip Goes a Million opened in London's West Side with Barbara in the cast. A special performance for members of the Royal Navy was filmed and aired in 1951, marking Barbara's television debut. The play was a huge success and ran for over a year, also spawning two touring companies. In 1955, Barbara made her television debut in the United States in an anthology show, The Pepsi-Cola Playhouse. She made her first appearance as a guest star in an ongoing series about a choreographer and his dancer wife in 1957, the same year she returned to Broadway in the musical Rumpel. That musical was not a success either, so Barbara turned to television in earnest beginning in 1959. She appeared in several series before she appeared in The Dick Van Dyke Show as the first actress to play Buddy's wife, Pickles, during season one. She played a recurring character in The Hathaways, a 1961 series about a family that had three chimpanzees as children. In 1963, she made her first appearance in Mayberry as Mary Lee Bechtel, a high school classmate of Andy and Barney who helped organize the class reunion. 10 episodes later, she was Lavinia, a single woman Barney thought might be a possible wife for Andy. 2 seasons later, she was Doris Williams, a fellow actor in the Centennial Founders Day pageant. And in the Color Years class reunion episode, she was Floss. She also appeared in an episode of the spinoff Gomer Pyle USMC. Barbara appeared in dozens of series throughout her long career, and also returned to Broadway one last time in the 1980s in Passionate Ladies, a play in which she not only acted, but also wrote. At the age of 95, Barbara is still with us and still acting, with her most recent appearance being just last year in an episode of Jake Galifianakis's comedy, Baskets. And Barbara has another connection to the Mayberry universe. She was married to Art Babbitt, a legendary animator best known for his work for Disney. He is credited with developing the character of Goofy. But more importantly for our purposes, he also worked on The Incredible Mr. Limpet, starring Don Knotts. Well, that's it for this week. Thanks for listening. And remember to take Andy's advice and go out there and act like somebody.
All right. Thank you, Randy, so much. That was fun. I didn't know anything about Barbara. That was a great report. If you'd like to make sure you don't miss any of Randy's online postings, send an email to turnersgrade@gmail.com, and he'll make sure you don't miss anything. So turnersgrade@gmail.com. Hey, and one more thing about Randy. Hey, guys, on Father's Day, he had a particularly good Father's Day this time because he was happy to introduce Benjamin, the newest honorary member of the Gomer and Goober Pyle Comic Book Literary Guild, and his grandson, I do believe. So congratulations to Randy, and thanks for all these great reports that you've been giving to us. We all enjoy them, have a great time. It's always fun to hear what you are able to dig up. So, folks, you are full up of history. The last 2 weeks, we have shared so much historical information about the Andy Griffith Show and related to the Andy Griffith Show. So I hope you guys are enjoying this. I know I do. It's fun to me to just find out new information and things that I haven't ever thought about before. So I want to thank, again, I want to thank Randy, and I want to thank James Middelton. Thank him for not only the information he gave us, but I honored him as the executive producer of this episode. Now, if you'd like to be an executive producer at some point in the future, you can go over to patreon.com and help support this show and all the other stuff I do related to the Andy Griffith Show. It would be great to have your support. Patreon.com. If you go to twochairsnowaiting.com, there's a link right there, and you can choose what you want to give. That's right. Well, folks, I want to thank you again for being here. I hope you've enjoyed it. I'd like to hear from you. Head over to twochairsnowaiting.com, click the contact button, and let me hear from you. You can give me a call at 888-684-8415. That information is under that contact button, so I'd love to hear from you. I always enjoy hearing from you, the fans. It's great. So, folks, until next time, have a great Mayberry week. And we'll see you next time right here on Two Chairs. See you later.